Hey guys, today we're taking a look at the G28 Wilderness in Ghost Recon Breakpoint. This is my favorite DMR. We're going to see how well this thing plays out and then test it out on both Sentinel and Wolf targets. But before we do that, let's set this thing up. I'm going to go over each part you'll need and then discuss my reasonings behind those choices. Also, I don't know if you guys noticed this yet lately, but I have been closing these videos off with the location. So if you do need the location, skip to the end and you can get it there and then come back here when you're ready. So let's get started. For the setup, we're going to use a DMR standard magazine, a DMR suppressor, a MULDA, a digital sight, and a bipod for the underbarrel. Now that we've set that up, let's test this thing against both Sentinel and Wolf targets, single shot, center mass, and we're going to see how well this thing takes them down. We're going to start off with Sentinel first with a suppressor. One shot confirmed. Moving on to Sentinel without a suppressor now. One shot confirmed. Moving on to Wolves with a suppressor. Three shots confirmed. Moving on to Wolves without a suppressor now. Three shots confirmed. You guys saw how much damage this thing does output based off of those tests alone. Even looking at the stats, this thing sits at a 54 damage output when you have it upgraded to MK3, so you will have phenomenal results all around with this thing in that area. But just to go over the parts that I used and why I chose the parts that I did. So I went with the MULDA. As you guys are aware, it is my favorite side for most guns. It's mostly that daytime visibility I needed this for, as well as that 10% increase to range. That decrease in shot spread by 20% is a nice touch, as well as that 10% reduction to sway, but this thing really doesn't even need those two bonuses. Like I said, I chose it mostly for that daytime visibility and that increase to range that it provides with this thing. Now, despite this game not actually having a deployable bipod for the underbarrel, I did still choose it, and it is because it is a smart choice to use on most of your rifles. It gives you a 10% reduction to horizontal recoil, as well as a 15% decrease in sway, but I mostly picked this thing again for that horizontal recoil and that 10% bonus it gives you to range when paired with that MULDA. That's a 20% boost to range overall. Now, for the scope, I went with a digital because it provides me a great medium to long range optic, but you could, of course, put on whatever scope you'll need for whatever job and mission you are on. But like I said, that digital will provide you a pretty good balance and it'll give you some pretty good coverage overall. So that's the G28 Wilderness. It's a fantastic choice overall for a rifle. It feels great. It looks great with that sweet ghillie wrapped look you got on there. So you can rock this thing in a lot of environments and get that immersion you are looking for. This gun is adaptable at all ranges. It's basically a shotgun too at close range. So do test that out and have some fun with it, because believe it or not, this is one of the funnest rifles to use in the game. So do copy that setup I gave you at the start. You can't go wrong with it. And that's the G28 Wilderness. As always, thank you guys for watching and take it easy.